Hello, this is Auke from WP Marketing Robot. In this video, I want to show you how to set up a basic Google feed. First step, create a feed, fill in a name, choosing the channel, target country, and the default category. The default category, I choose clothing, even though there are a lot of other categories in the shop. The default category is set to apparel and clothing. Updating schedule is the time when you want to the plugin to recreate the feed. So the feed always has the latest product data like prices and removed or new products, etc. Next step is the category mapping. Select all the categories from the products we want to include in our feed. After that, we can map the products in a category in a Google category. By default, it is connected to the earlier chosen default category. With the drop-downs, you can easily choose the right Google category the products belong to. When mapping a Google category to a top-level product category, the child categories are mapped to the same Google category. Products from the product categories you did not select will not be included in the Google feed. Well, this is basically it. You can save your feed and start using it. There are settings that in some cases can cause a feed not to be valid for Google. For example, if you do not have an SKU for each product, you would need to change the ID to something like post ID, a unique ID. Another example is that you need to have a unique identifier, like a GTIN number, MPN and brand. If you miss these identifiers, you can set the identifier exist to false. Please note that setting it to false for products that do have an identifier will not work. Google will disapprove those products or even suspend your account. Under highly recommended, you find the product type field. And this field represents your webshop product category. And I always set it to product category string. Try to set as many highly recommended fields as you possibly can, like the MPN and its bundle field. Next step is saving your feed and check the feed in the feed lists. It will show you the feed URL, how many products there are in the feed, the status of the feed, and action links. When you click the View button, you can view the feed in your browser. Note that every browser shows the feed different, and you should get familiar how to see the XML code in your particular browser. The last step is to activate your feed. This will make the plugin renew the feed with the earlier set update schedule of the feed settings. Thanks for watching. Please let us know if you have any question about using the plugin and get the best out of it.